living and dead who did these things, we dedicate this program,
The Dam Busters,
presented by the author himself, Paul Brickhill, dramatized by Maurice West, an Australasian radio production.
About the middle of 1943, disturbing reports were coming out of Germany about a mysterious new weapon, apparently Hitler's notorious secret weapon. British agents reported that thousands of workmen were swarming over monstrous new concrete structures in the Pas-de-Calais area, only 60 miles from London. The British War Cabinet didn't know then that these were the rocket launching sites from which London would be bombarded by the V-1s and V-2s. But they did know enough to be extremely worried. Britain had to have a bomb capable of destroying them. It was because of this that Barnes Wallace was told to go ahead with his earthquake bomb. And it was because of this, too, that 617 Squadron was moved to a new airfield at Coningsby. They sensed at once that something was in the wind, and it put new zest into them.
Happy with the squadron, Holder?
Quite happy, sir. Things are a little chancy for a few days, but they've settled down.
Good. I've got a new training program for you.
I was hoping for new operations, sir.
Oh, you'll get them. As soon as Wallace has got his new bombs ready, they're going to take a crack at the rocket installations on the French coast.
Low-flying?
That's right. Low-flying with lots and lots of flak. Well, they're the Germans' last hope, and they know it. They're putting everything they've got into them.
What sort of aircraft are we going to use?
Well, Lancasters. They'll be modified, of course. That's being done now. But you'll be working with fighter escort.
I'd still like an operation, sir. Otherwise, the boys will be getting very browned off.
I've got one for you. At short order, you'll only need 8 crews. Now come over here. I want you to take a look at this. This, here, is the Dortmund-Ems Canal.
Yes, I know it. It's a sticky run.
That canal is the principal freight link between the Ruhr and central and eastern Germany. Intelligence reports indicate that 33 million tons a year is freighted along that single waterway. And only a small fraction of that could be carried by rail. Particularly now, when we've made such a mess of the Ruhr.
I see. So if we could breach the canal...
You'd cause the biggest traffic jam of all time. Now, look here. This is Laudbergen. At this point, the land level falls away, and the canal is actually above the level of the surrounding countryside. If you can bust the wall of that canal, you'll flood the country, cut off coal from the Ruhr. Oh, and there's one other thing. The Germans are floating prefabricated U-boats down this same canal.
We could do a good job for the Navy, then.
That's right.
It smells like a decent show, sir. When do we do it?
Conditions being favorable, September the 14th.
Right, chaps. Now, you know your target. You know the purpose of the operation. Now, take a look at the flak points. Here, here, and here.
This is a short order flight. We're not going to have any chance to engage the flak ourselves.
I know that, Maltby. You'll have night fighter escort.
No, oh, that's a break anyway, sir.
It's a small target, so we're going to pinpoint it for you with a flare. We've had one especially designed for the job, and you won't be able to miss it. Are there any questions?
Yes, sir. The country around the canal is pretty low-lying. Now, even if the night's clear on the run-in, there's a chance there'll be fog over the target.
Yes, well, that's quite all right. We've thought of that. As a matter of fact, a weather mosquito will go in first.
Oh, I see.
If the target's obscured, then we'll get word from group, and we'll turn back. Now, is that clear, everybody?
Yes, sir.
All right, chaps. We take off at 18:30 hours. Good luck.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Don't worry, Anne, darling. This isn't the dam's rain. It's a piece of cake.
Might have been a piece of cake before, David. It isn't now. We're going to be married in a week. If anything happens...
I know. Look, darling, nothing can possibly happen. They've given us fighter escort, the whole works. I'll be home for breakfast.
I love you, David. I love you so very much. You know that.
Oh, darling. Now dry your eyes, sweetheart. Yeah, everything's going to be all right. Look how well it's turned out for us so far. You've got a posting right next door to me.
Oh, David, did you get the license?
What? Oh, hell no, I forgot all about it. Never mind, I'll fix that when I come back. Oh, no.
What now?
I forgot to book a pub in London. Darling, it looks as though we'll spend our honeymoon under a haystack.
Darling, you're quite impossible. We'll never get married at this rate.
You're going out tonight, darling?
Yes, Mrs. Maltby. Your loving husband is going to inspect some waterworks.
Is it a bad one this time, darling?
No, not really. We've got a heavy escort of fighters, so there's nothing to it, really. Except deliver the eggs on target and come home.
You didn't sleep very well last night, did you?
No, much the same. The old nightmares. When I come back from this one, I'll see the doc. Get him to give me a tonic or something.
Darling, you were shouting in your sleep again last night.
Oh, was I? What was I saying?
The same thing. The thing you always say. The bomb won't come off. The bomb won't come off.
Well, silly, isn't it? You'd think I'd be dreaming about flak or fighters. Some of the really dangerous things. Just shows you how crazy it all is. Well, darling, it's time to go.
Darling, we've been very happy, haven't we?
We have been. We are. We always will be. Wish me luck, sweetheart.
Good luck, sweetheart. God keep you.
Speed, 245 miles per hour. We should be on target in 1 hour, 20 minutes.
Okay. Thanks, navigator. Captain to wireless operator, would you signal Maltby and Shannon to come alongside and hold formation until we cross the coast, then spread out for the flak?
Wireless operator to captain, signaling now. Captain, Mrs. Van Boom. When the mosquito reports heavy fog over target, return to base immediately.
Thanks, Wabi. Captain to crew, weather conditions unsuitable for bombing. Repeat, unsuitable for bombing. We are returning to base. Would you give me a course, navigator? Captain to wireless operator, please give me RT to flight.
Wireless operator to captain, you're on now, skipper.
Leader to flight. Leader to flight. Come in, please. Over.
Okay, leader, we're in. They happen.
Yeah, mother, we're in.
Leader to all aircraft. Weather conditions unsuitable. Repeat, unsuitable for bombing. We are returning to base. Repeat, we are returning to base.
Not after all this running.
Skip it, Shannon. Radio silence till we get home. Captain to rear gunner. Would you keep an eye on the rest of the flight? I don't expect any trouble. We've got fighter escort.
Rear gunner to captain.
I'm watching, skipper.
Shannon's made his turn. He's all right.
Maltby's coming round now.
Yeah, I don't like the look of this, skipper. He's too low. He's much too low. He'll be in if he doesn't... His wingtip's in, skipper. He's cartwheeled. Oh, God, he's in the drink. Maltby's in, skipper. Maltby's in.
Captain Wireless operator, please give me RT.
You're on, skipper.
This is leader calling A. Apple. Maltby's in the drink. Circle him until the rescue boys come out. Send a signal for a fix. Stay until the rescue boys show up. Over.
Okay, leader, I'll hang around. It doesn't look so good. They went in nose first. I can't see anything yet. The water's still boiling. I'll direct the rescue boys. Over.
Captain Navigator, please give me a course.
I beg your pardon. I thought it was my husband.
I'm George Holden, Mrs. Maltby. Do you mind if I come in?
Yes. Yes, of course.
I've got a message for you, Mrs. Maltby.
From my husband?
Well, about your husband. He had an accident on the way home. Had to put down in the sea. The rescue plane's gone out.
He's dead, isn't he?
Well, there's always hope until... But I wouldn't hope too much. It was quick, Mrs. Maltby. They wouldn't have felt a thing.
I think he expected it. I think we both expected it. It's like that when you're married, isn't it?
The squadron was shocked by David Maltby's death, particularly as the mishap had occurred miles from enemy territory. But the course of the war doesn't alter because a pilot is killed. That night, the raid was to be on again. Holden was wearily drawing up a new battle order when Mickey Martin strolled into the orderly room. He had just come back from leave.
Hello, Martin.
Hi, Skipper. Hell, you look tired. Bad night last night?
I didn't even get to the ruddy target. Fog. Had to turn home. Maltby's gone. Pitched in the drink.
How'd his wife take it?
Very well. It's hell for the girls. Going out again tonight.
Are you, by George? Can I come?
You don't have to.
Well, who the hell said anything about having to? Can I come or can't I?
Sorry, Mickey, of course you can't. I'd be glad to have you.
I'll just go and stow my gear away. I'll see you in the mess.
Mickey, you're crazy, sticking your neck out like that.
Oh, shut up, Max. My own neck.
Hello, Martin. I believe you're coming with us tonight.
That's right, night, old boy.
I'm very glad you've come.
Did you hear that, Mac? There's a man of taste and discretion. Yeah. Best friend I've got on the station. Hello. A lot of wafts about tonight.
Yeah, a lot of new blood. The boys are on their best behavior. For a little while, anyway.
Oh, hello, Mac.
Hello. You met Knight, haven't you? Miss Cheswick, this is Mickey Martin.
I've heard a lot about you.
Wait for it, brother. Wait for it.
You've been on leave, haven't you?
Yeah. That's right. I'm glad to know somebody cared.
Now, look, don't distract him. He's going out tonight.
Well, I hope they do better than they did last night. Yeah, you see, he's gone to an awful lot of trouble over this operation.
To hell with you and all the damned AOCs. What about the seven lives in every aircraft?
Well, if that's the sort of talk I get from officers and gentlemen.
I'm sorry, Mickey. I'm a bit upset over Maltby, I guess.
Now, skip it, Mac. She wasn't my type anyway.
Well, don't be too hard on her, Mac. She's very new, and they don't really understand, do they?
Navigator to captain. Navigator to captain. Nordorn's coming up to port now. From Nordorn, your new course will be at 090 degrees magnetic. Repeat, 090 degrees magnetic.
Okay, Navigator. 090 degrees magnetic. Captain to rear gunner. Rear gunner, would you watch out for flak as we come in on the turn?
Gunner to captain. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
Captain to bomb aimer. Captain to bomb aimer. Watch out for flak, old boy.
Bomb aimer to captain. No sign yet. Hello. Starting now.
They're close, skipper. Pull her up a bit. Up! Up! Break away! Leader's boarded! Oh, God, he's hit smack into the middle of the town!
Martin to all aircraft. We are holding course. Stand by for orders. We are holding course. Stand by for orders. Over.
Please.
calling Queen Queenie. Leader calling Queen Queenie. Report, please. Captain to crew. Wilson and Duval seem to have bought it. I'm going in again. Watch it, bomb, Eva. You won't get a second chance. Going down, boys. Going down. Bomb aim at the captain. I can see it now. Okay. I'll give it full circle and come in on the other side. I'm on it now, Skipper. Left a bit. Left. Right a little. Right. Steady. Steady. Bomb gone. I missed it, Skipper. We missed it. Okay, boys. Home we go.
Martin, how was it?
Pretty dicey, sir, as a matter of fact. I'm terribly sorry we didn't breach it. The mist beat us and the flak.
Not your fault, Martin.
Look here, sir, I'm terribly disappointed about tonight. But if the weather's clear tomorrow, well, it's tonight now. And if you let us have another crack, I think we'll get it. I'll take the same boys out. They know the run now.
Martin, how many crews have you left?
Well, there are three in my flight and three more in Dave Shannon's. I think that ought to be enough, sir.
Six. Six out of 617's original 21. And you think you'll do it with six crews?
Well, it ought to be enough, sir. I'm just sorry about last night.
I don't think you have to apologize for anything, Martin. I'll let you know later whether we'll take another crack. You go and get some sleep.
Yes, sir. Good night. Good morning, sir.
Get some sleep, Martin.
Can I come in, Mickey?
Yes, Mac. Nice to see you. Oh, look, got a cigarette?
Sure. Here you are.
Good. Oh, boy, thanks.
Well, come on, Mickey, get it off your chest.
Oh, look, Mac, the first time I lead them, the very first time we missed the target, 617 missed it.
It's not your fault, Mickey.
Look, if we'd had even an ounce of luck. You see, Mac, when I came in on my last run, I could see the Ruddy Canal and... Oh, never mind.
Well, it's better anyway. Here, take one of these knockout drops. You need one. Go on, take it right now.
Thanks. Mac, you know, we lost a lot of the boys.
How many?
Five crews.
Holy mackerel, five out of eight. Mickey, that must be a hell spot.
You say that again. It is. Mac.
Yeah?
If we got another crack at it, we could do it this time.
What? Another crack at it?
Yeah.
Five crews gone and you want to have another crack at it? Oh, no, 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 Mickey. You're crazy as a coot. You can't do it, laddie boy. You mustn't.
Well, I've already asked Cochrane.
And what did he say?
Well, he said he'd think about it.
If he lets you do that, he's a ruddy murderer.
I think he feels that way, too. But I mean it, Mac. I want another crack at that canal.